As you've heard Eric and I talk about this race from the internal polling we've seen from very credible sources, people who really accurately predicted some of the state by state elections in the presidential contest. I've certainly had many conversations with pollsters like my friend Adam Geller, who is also Donald Trump's pollster. You know, the race is probably about 7 points right now. And that's with a good 20%+ undecided. So, as always, it comes down to turnout. I want to introduce you to my friend Rob Zweigart, who is basically going to be, he will be the next chairman of the Morris County Republicans. And, you know, Morris County plays a very critical role here because depending on how many local races there are, it's going to impact the turnout. And if the turnout is high on voters who are already committed, that's going to impact the outcome for sure. So, Rob, tell me what's going on. Local race, while you and I were talking the other day, and I wanted you to come on and explain this to our listeners, that in a race like this, where you're going to have a relatively low voter turnout across the board, there are going to be pockets that matter. This happened in the Corzine election, if we recall, when Christie beat him. What happened was the turnout in the cities was incredibly low, and I see potentially that same trend now. And then that coupled with a high Republican turnout, Monmouth, Morris, et cetera, this race could come down to a few points. What do you think?
I mean, I agree, Billy. I mean, when you look at Christie's election, you had great turnout with Republicans in Ocean, in Morris and Monmouth, and that really pushed them over the top, and we need that now.
Yeah.
You see Kim's campaign out all the time in Morris County. Carlos was out last night in Morris County. And our concern up here is we have 39 towns in Morris County. There's 29 contested races for a general election. If you had 15, because it's a Republican county, that would be a lot. So 29 contested races is a tremendous amount. And we're noticing a ton of money flowing in on the Democratic side. Morris County, as you know, is mostly a suburb county. It doesn't have inner cities. It's not urban.
Mm-hmm.
The biggest town in the county, Parsippany,
yeah,
they are throwing in up to $300,000 for a municipal race.
Wow.
That's 300 grand. Traditionally, up here in Morris County, in some of the small towns, if you have a council race during a general, maybe they knock on doors, maybe they have a little lunch, they do one mailer, they spend a couple of $1,000. $25,000 are being spent on council races up here for a general election.
Yeah.
So that's the concern is that I agree with you with the inner cities. We want to keep that vote low, but we also need that vote to turn out in Mars and Ocean in those towns for a victory for Kim. And the money that's flowing in Mars County, we've never seen it.
Well, you know, Rob, I mean, I look at it this way, that I think that this whole strategy, I mean, I would like to see city votes turn out and folks in Newark and Irvington and Patterson realize that the solution is not throwing more money at the problem, because you look at what's happening in the city. So that's the only thing I take issue with. And a lot of Republicans will always say, they're like, hey, we got to hope for a low turnout here. I think it's going to happen, but I think it's going to happen because Republicans, and maybe, you know, you're going to be different. And I think you are. I've known you for a long time. You're a smart guy. You're a leader. You get it. We need Republicans who are going to go to the cities and explain to people why the things are as bad as they are and how we can make them better. I think that's the problem. You know, Christie paid some lip service to it, but then never followed through. He didn't follow through with it. And things just have continued to get worse, save for places like Newark, where it's starting to come back slowly because of the leadership of Ross Baraka and Anthony Ambrose. But I think it's a very important point, and I think you agree, that it's time to start enlightening people to say, look, you don't have to vote the way you voted for the last 30 years. You can vote for the person who's got a better idea.